I am Simon Lin. I'm from Academia Sinica, and I am responsible for the grid and cloud centers in Academia Sinica.
And your presentation earlier was talking about the different examples in Asia of using computing, scientific computing, for climate change modeling. What specifically are you doing in Taiwan using the grid for? What climate models are you building? Is this for tsunamis or for other types of natural disasters?
Perhaps I should start it with saying that we are, especially this talk is about infrastructure for the climate change. So this is the area traditionally been regarded for the supercomputing or large clusters, but because of the progress of the computing facilities, it now becomes possible to run the climate change application on the infrastructure. So my talk is basically talking about the, first of all, the common issues of the area, where, for example, traffic storm is one issue, and then all the seasonal winds and the interaction of the continental air system with the oceanic system. And especially, this will give you the frontal of the of these pressure lines, and then especially during certain seasons, it may bring enormous amount of rain. And the whole context is actually about the issue of the global warming, where we have the very detailed data shows that, for example, in case of Taiwan, the temperatures increase 1.1 from 1970.
I see.
Yeah, so that's it. I call it island warming. It's actually, of course, it's not just simple, and there was a complicated a lot of factors together to make the temperature rise.
And do you work with other countries such as Vietnam or Thailand to link up your infrastructures, your e-infrastructures,
yeah,
for these models? Do you focus, say, on working just in Taiwan? How is that set up? Are you well networked with other countries?
Yeah, because we are part of this EGI Inspire as well, the chain project, and then the previous EU-Asia Grid. So the previous project didn't really stop. We carry on with the previous work. So there is a big genetic theme, which is related with all the disaster brought not just by the rain, by the storms, and not just the water, the flood, and as well as the earthquake, tsunami.
Okay.
So in this particular setting of climate change, because WWF happened to be one of the easiest software to be ported on the grid,
yeah,
and it's actually very helpful. It can do weather prediction, the trace of a typhoon, and then also the large scale of the climate change.
Okay, and do you also use clouds with grids in Taiwan?
Yes, we use cloud, but not for this purpose, because mainly because this application still require the MPI over grid. MPI over grid.
And what is that?
Oh, it's to be able to support what traditionally called high performance computing on the federation of clusters. So what happened now is that we have a portal. So the scientists of climate change in area, they can log into the portal and they submit their jobs with the proper parameter, and it will run on the most appropriate and available resources.
And in your opinion, what is a cloud?
Cloud, I think it's basically a commercial buzzword. Miron Lebeny, who is the person who created Condo, is a very well-respected and old veteran of the field of distributed computing. And he said, there is no new thing under the sunshine. It's the quote in the words of Solomon. And I think there's a lot of things which is not new at all. From the cloud computing, but I think the most valuable thing of cloud is actually the virtualization capabilities.
Okay.
Where it will bring in the flexibilities that is not available, not possible before. So I have this criteria where whether one has to adopt a new technology, the technology must be able to do something that was not possible before. So if you look at that, the most valuable thing will be on the flexibility of management. So the possibility is whether one will be able to support HPC node or HPC virtual machines on the cloud is still an open question. Yeah.
And my last question to you is, what do you hope to get out of this conference as a whole? What do you hope your objective is? What do you plan to get out of it?
Well, I'm here to present on the works of the community in Asia Pacific working on the climate change. So first of all, we would like to get our jobs or works to be known by other communities in order to maybe build new connections and possibilities to work with other communities. Because e-science is also a powerful concept or idea that if one exploited to the limit, one might be able to do things that was not possible.
Sure. Yeah. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.